Have you ever put a lot of effort into learning a new machine learning algorithm and you mastered it? And after that, a new fancier and more complicated machine learning algorithm made it to the state of the art? And now you need to learn that? Well, that makes two of us. In this video, I will share with you the one concept that will help you understand any machine learning algorithm faster. So let's assume that this black box is any machine learning algorithm out there, that it has some inputs, data, and some outputs, which are whatever we want to predict or classify. You can think of this black box as a function with some parameters in it, like X, Y, Z. And it's helpful to think of these parameters as some sliders that we slide left and right. Every time we slide these parameters, the output will change accordingly. Just to give you some examples of what this black box could be, it could be as simple as a linear regression model. And in that case, these parameters will be the slope and the y-intercept of that linear regression model. Or it could be as complicated as an artificial neural network. And in that case, these parameters will be the weights between the neurons. Let's see how we can get the best outputs. I'll explain this using two examples. The first one is using supervised learning, while the second one is using unsupervised learning. Well, let's move that cube from here. Well, in supervised learning, we usually have known outputs, like the truth values. Conventionally, we use the term y in order to indicate them. We have three values here, 10, 20, 25. These could be anything, like age, weight, doesn't matter. And our black box gives us a close but not exact predicted values, represented as y hat. 15, 20, and 20. Now we need to measure how good our model is. One way to do that is by defining the differences between the predicted and ground truth, 5, 0, 5, squaring them to remove the minus effect, and then finding the average. So we need to add them up and divide them by 3. And we get the result. This number reflects how good our model is. It's a relative number, so the 16.6 doesn't mean anything now, but we will use it to compare it with other models. This number is also called a metric. So the first takeaway here is that we need to tune these parameters to get the best value of our metrics. Oh, we run out of space here. Let's push them to the left. Even more. That's better. Now let's try a different combination of the black box parameters and assess the output as we just did. Let's draw the tweaks on the x-axis and the goodness of our model on the y-axis. The second tweak uses a different combination. You know what? I changed my mind. Let's label the y-axis as how bad the model is instead of how good the model is. How to save this? I'll say far from goodness means badness. The higher the value, the larger the error, the lower the value, the better the model is. Hope that makes sense. Now we connect all three dots together to get our error curve. We now see that the second trial is the best, smallest error. For unsupervised example, I'll use k-nearest neighborhood algorithm as an example. If you're not familiar with KNN, it's a clustering algorithm that divides points into groups. Let's say the first trial gives us these red potential centroids of the three groups. We can see that they are far from being good, as the average distance between each point and the belonging centroid are not small enough. I'll make sure this time that I label the y-axis correctly. Low value is good, bad value is bad. In the second trial, the green dots, seems better, as the average distances between each point and the belonging centroid are small enough. In the third trial, the blue squares seem a lot worse. This method of tuning some parameters to minimize an error is called optimization. This is the core concept of every machine learning algorithm, and I encourage you to learn it to better understand any machine learning algorithm out there. And that's our second takeaway. One more important note here is that the error curve doesn't always look as simple as I drew earlier. It could be as ugly as this, or even more. So we need a mathematical or automated way to find the optimal parameters that gives us the lowest error possible. Luckily, we have several optimization algorithms out there. We can categorize them into three groups: the first order optimization algorithms, high order optimization algorithms, and heuristics. For example, the famous gradient descent algorithm is a first order optimization algorithm, while genetic algorithm belongs to the heuristic category. If you want to know more about these, just stay tuned, pun intended. Sorry, I couldn't resist. So that's it. For any new machine learning algorithm you want to study, always view it as an optimization problem and ask what parameters I need to tune, what metrics should I be minimizing, and what optimization algorithm should I use. If you learned anything from this video, please like, share, and subscribe. To the next time.